20 years later, in 753 BC, on the occasion of the pagan rites of the Lupercalia, Amulius, the tyrant of Alba Longa, celebrated the coming marriage of his ward Curtius with Julia, the daughter of the powerful king of the Sabines.
There's so many people here today.
It's the feast of the god Pan. It's to him we owe the fruits of the earth.
That's right. There's one over there.
Isn't she beautiful?
Yes, she is. But don't forget why we came here.
How dare you refuse to give an offering? Don't you want good crops next year?
But what harvest can I have? I don't even own the smallest piece of land.
You got those animals,
but
you give them to me.
No.
They'll be of use in bringing you the blessing of the god Pan.
And King Amulius.
No, not my animals, no!
Let us go, my sons. The ceremony is about to start.
No. Oh, what will I do now?
Don't worry, old one. The gods will protect you.
Vestal guardian of the Temple of Mars.
Here comes King Amulius.
Thank you. in your honor, O god Pan. May this propitious rite be celebrated. Accept our offerings. Let the sacrifice be made.
Hey, to me! To me!
Is it true that the crowd wants to be whipped with the skins of the animals sacrificed?
Yes. They say it brings prosperity.
As well as good fortune and love.
You were a stranger like I was, who came here by chance. That's why I grabbed you. Those whippings are useless torture and shouldn't be seen by eyes as beautiful as yours. My name's Romulus. What's yours?
How dare you touch me?
I see you like to struggle.
You
shouldn't hit my brother on the head. He was enchanted by your beauty.
That's right. I swear it.
Julia, I've been looking all over for you. Why did you run away? Has anyone been treating you with disrespect?
No. These two shepherd boys helped me to get out of the cabins of the Lupercalia. Be kind enough to reward them. They deserve it.
You heard her. Do as your mistress says.
You pig! How dare you speak that way to me?
Stop it, Curtius.
As you wish. If you were even half as courageous as you are insolent, why don't you take part in the race of the Burning Hurdles?
I'll be there. What's the name of your mistress?
Julia, the daughter of Tarsus, king of the Sabines.
By the gods. She's the daughter of a king.
You could have spoiled our whole plan.
Yes, I know. But it's all for the best. While I'm racing tonight, the guards will be distracted. It'll be easier for you.
I agree, but we have no time to waste if we expect our plan to succeed. All right, come on.
Remus.
Why are you here, Tarpeia?
Why should I wait for you in camp? I can be more useful to you here.
It's no work for a woman.
Why not, Remus? Tarpeia rides like a man and fights like one.
Everything has been prepared. Don't be angry with me, Remus. Please don't.
I don't like people to disobey my orders.
I came only because I wanted to be near you.
That isn't necessary.
What are you doing here? Are you mad? You know what they would do to a man who was found inside the tent of the goddess Vesta.
I'm here to thank the goddess. For years I've been seeking you. I tended the flocks of your father Numitor in the year of the double moon. You were only a girl. Try to remember. You were missing two of those, aren't you? Years ago it was. I came upon two baby boys, raised by a she-wolf. They have medals like the ones you're wearing.
Have, you say? You mean they're still alive?
I raised those boys as if they were my own.
And today they're here. One is tall, his complexion is dark. His eyes are a deep blue color.
Yes. Romulus is tall, and he has blue eyes. How do you know?
He passed close to me today. He has the same eyes exactly.
But if you've never seen him before, the same eyes as who?
Those of a god. Hurry, you must go now. We will talk of this again.
The sacred fire is burning low. From my tent, I saw it growing dim. That's why I've come. I want no more bad omens. I see that eternal shadow of hostility in your eyes. But there was a time when it was not there. After Numidor died.
After you had him killed, you mean?
He was a weakling. He was not fit to reign. Besides, so many years have passed since then. You have consecrated yourself to Vesta so that you could refuse my love. Here before you are the results. A lonely woman and a lonely king.
Forgive me, Amulius, but the games cannot begin without your presence.
Doing here, woman?
Be nice to a girl who likes a brave warrior more than watching those silly games.
I'll be just as good to you as you deserve.
Really?
Just give me a chance to prove it.
What's going on?
the Shepherd has won the race.
And I have lost.
Who is that on the white horse?
He is Romulus, only the son of a shepherd.
What is it?
Thieves! They've stolen all the horses!
They must be caught. I'm going to have the heads of those brigands.
There they are! They're coming! They're coming! There they are with the horses!
We've done it again. The fruit stolen by Amulius has been returned to its trees.
Where's Romulus?
He fell behind because he's carrying a load as fragile as eggs.
What do you mean?
The blonde Sabine looked better to him than horses. Frankly, I don't blame him.
The gods have clouded his brain. We've got two enemies now instead of one. The king of the Sabines will have our skins for this.
Remus, come. Your father's badly wounded. Hurry.
I beg of you, let me down.
But where would you go? You don't know the way. Better stop here. The horse is lame. And don't try and run away. I can run faster than you. Julia!
No, no, let me go.
Stubborn and proud. That's what I like.
Romulus. I don't hear his voice.
He's here beside me. We are with you, Father.
Grieve not. Don't weep for me. For I've deceived you all these years.
What are you saying, Father?
While there, the joy of hearing you say this word kept me from telling you the truth. Now I must speak. I'm not really your father. I found you in a she-wolf's den. You're the son of a god, Andrea Silvia.
wait here until the rain stops. Don't be afraid. I won't eat you.
Weren't the horses your friend stole enough for you?
You're worth more than the whole herd. And you're prettier than a horse. But I was speaking of the ransom. Your father's a king. Even Amulius pays him tribute. But this time, he'll have to pay. Undress. And dry yourself. Or you'll catch cold. The lords of Alba Longa, or the Sabines, they're all the same. Thieves who steal from other thieves. They wear a crown, but they're still thieves. You want some?
No, I'm not thirsty.
It'll warm you up.
Does it seem honest to you what you're doing?
This hut is Numa's, a friend of mine.
It's not the wine I'm speaking of.
I have to make a living. And my way isn't the worst.
Stealing?
Once we were just shepherds and so poor, we felt lucky to eat. And so peaceful, we kissed the hand that whipped us. But now things have changed. We are many, all of us desperate men, trying to get back what's been taken from us.
Sacrificing the lives of others?
You can die of hunger, too.
Oh, you could have found honest work in Alba Longa.
Yes, we could have. But we've another fault. We love freedom. The place where we were born. The mountains, the rivers, the valleys. Our land.
No, it isn't necessary to live like thieves just because you want freedom. You can easily be free in any city where the law is really law. And is respected by everyone.
Perhaps. If there was such a city. But that's not Alba Longa. The rain stopped.
In this land, you are a foreigner as I am. You have no choice. A prisoner must be taken to King Amulius. The decision is his.
This is the second time that you've interfered between me and this brigand. I'm here as your father's representative.
That has nothing to do with this. We cannot risk the alliance between Amulius and my people.
Warn Remus!
Go after him! Don't let him get away!
Remus.
A god. I'm the son of a god and Rhea Sylvia. Faustulus wasn't my father.
What are you saying?
I've known it for a long time. Something different flows in my veins, something superior to the others. Albalonga is mine. Amulia sits on my throne. I am the true king of that city. I'll kill Amulius and change his laws. I'll make Albalonga the greatest city in the world. Greater than Thebes, greater than Nineveh. If only I had some real men, instead of these spineless shepherds. Servius and Sulpicius, perhaps, but the others...
Remus!
Here comes Numa. I don't know, but look at his face. Come on, let's go see. Let's all go see.
What can it be? Remus! Down there at my cabin in the valley. Romulus has been captured by Amulius' men, led by Curtius the Sabine.
That madman, how could he be so foolish? Where is he?
He defended himself as long as he could, but he was outnumbered.
Now all of us will get in trouble. They'll find out our hiding place, and in no time they'll descend on us because of that woman.
Romulus is no coward. Burn him alive and he wouldn't talk.
Servius is right, though.
Of course. None of us is safe here any longer.
We have to get out of here.
We can hide in the forest.
Quick, it's best if we all separate.
Let's divide the spoils.
Silence! We will not run and we'll not divide the spoils. Romulus is my brother. We'll go to Albalonga and free him. The time has come, I'm sure of it.
You mean to send these men into battle with no arms, no knowledge of combat?
We'll get weapons from the enemy.
But these men don't even know how to use them.
They'll learn how to use them or they will die.
And who are you to be giving us orders? We don't have any chiefs. That's our law.
Wrong, Servius. There is a chief, and you're speaking to him.
But first we'll see if we'll accept them.
Let's get out of the way.
Of anyone who opposes my will. If anyone else wants to speak, let him speak now. To the new men who have joined us, I ask nothing about your past. It doesn't interest me. All I want to know is if you are ready to use your sword against a tyrant and false king. We're worthy of leading a people, not of being driven through these mountains like outlaws and hunted down like dogs. Follow me and I will give you a city. I will make you rich and powerful. You will have real homes. What do the soldiers of Amulius have that should frighten us so? Arms of bronze and gold to pay for them? Well, we can have them too. We will attack Albalonga, the city will be ours. I am ready to give all my blood for this, to die for this. All I'm asking from you is your loyalty and courage. Are you with me?
And robber of sheep, are you going to talk? Tell me where your friends are hiding, and your life will be spared. Where are those jackals who've had the audacity to defy Amulius? Don't be stubborn, my shepherd boy. My patience is wearing thin. Well, I'm waiting. So you've decided not to speak. But within 2 days, the Sabine Lancers will add to the strength of my forces. And none of you will escape me. And you will die before the rest. Then when it is too late, you'll bitterly regret your muted tongue.
Ah!
Save your ferocity for tomorrow.
How I hate it here. The cruelty, the indecency of these people. I wish I'd never come to this city. I feel as though I were being held prisoner here. Even if I ran away and returned to my father, it wouldn't resolve anything. It's too late to turn back, don't you see?
When we arrived in Avalonga, you were so different. Could it be the young shepherd who has brought this change of heart?
Quiet, Hester. Don't say that.
Julia, we're to be treated to a spectacle, courtesy of Amulius. Your shepherd friend should prove easy prey for the bears. I'm sure you'll enjoy seeing your abductor clawed to pieces by that beast. And you have me to thank for saving you, Julia. Did you know your father was coming?
My father?
Yes, the sentries of Amulius report that he's already set out. You see, it's his wish that a marriage be hurried. Amulius has no heirs, so his kingdom shall be mine. I have made myself indispensable to him.
Good luck.
Why do you suppose that Tatius has given me your hand with such enthusiasm?
I don't know my father's motives, but I'm not in love with you, Curtius, and you know it.
No matter, Julia. But you'll learn, I promise you. When everything has been concluded, in accordance with the will of the gods. Excited, my dear? You're about to be avenged.
Here, catch it! Hurry! Climb up, take hold of the rope. Time is running short, hurry!
Right.
Climb up quickly!
Best as you can, Caius.
All these preparations are useless. We'll be lucky if we can find the shreds of that rebel.
Amulius likes a good show. If the bear doesn't kill Romulus,
we'll tickle him a bit with the points of our swords.
Ready, archers? Go!
heart's beating. She's still alive.
The entire city is in flames. We must escape immediately.
We've got to get out of here as quickly as possible. We'll have to try to reach your father. He may be in the hills. He'll be sure to stifle this shepherd's rebellion.
Let me go. Don't touch me.
You belong to me. This is my will and the will of your father, King Titus.
Leave her alone! Oh, no!
My king, Alba Longa is in flames, and your daughter was taken by the rebels. 5 times the sun has gone down since the moment when I saw her abducted, taken violently. They're already far away. The Alba Longa are with them. My wounds are the proof of my resistance.
Make them pay for this, the miserable curs. I'll pursue them without resting until I've destroyed them all. It's not just a city these rebels have burned. They've offended the king of the Sabines.
one of them shall survive to recall the shame of Alba Longa.
Forward!
Journey ahead of us, and we've just started. Don't forget that.
Stop the caravan! Unhitch the horses! When they're fed, you can rest until sundown.
We're stopping here! Tie the horses to the wagon!
Hitching all their wagons.
Take your best men. Go after the caravan immediately.
Save some wine. We've a long way to go yet. You look tired. Why don't you rest? Do you regret your decision?
Oh, the wagon's not as comfortable as my sedan chair, but no matter. Romulus, what's on the other side of the swamp? I've heard nobody's ever been able to get through it.
That's true. But I believe the prophecy of my mother. Beyond the swamp and the mountain of fire, we'll find a valley surrounded by seven hills with a river. There we'll build our city. There we'll build our hearth fires.
The sentinels have reported that they have seen a great many flocks of birds rising into the sky. Maybe it's only a few animals, but I'm afraid it means cavalry.
Remus, did you hear that?
Yes.
Could it be the Sabines?
I don't know. I'll go and explore. You take command of the caravan.
No, I'll go. You're more suited to stay here than I am. I'm too kind-hearted. You said so yourself, remember?
All right, but whatever you do, do it in a hurry. And don't get yourself in trouble.
Jailers, let's go!
If it should be my father, I could be of great danger to you.
Perhaps, and perhaps not.
You don't think so?
You may be worth something as a hostage. That's the only reason you're alive.
You'd just as soon drown me in the swamp. And you hate your brother for having heart. The two of you don't seem like brothers save in appearance. You are different, Remus. What's tormenting you?
Romulus is different since he met you. But I don't think he has it in him to command. When we were boys, if we found a reed, I would make a sword and he would make a flute. I dreamt of commanding men. He was happy to have a woman by his side. Perhaps he is right. Women don't appreciate soldiers.
Women appreciate men who are men. Poet or soldier, doesn't matter.
Remus. Acronon, Sulpicius, and some of the others ask permission to light their fires.
No, not now. We'll wait till Romulus gets back. Then we march.
Is it true that your father's chasing the caravan?
Yes, and I'm afraid. He'd have mercy for no one if he should overtake us.
Why don't you go to him? Why don't you run away? Maybe you could make him understand.
It's no longer possible. You see, it's fate, not the horses, that moves the wheels of the carts.
Fresh.
What have you found, soldier?
These tracks were made by the caravan, my king, no doubt about it.
I think I know where they're going. Take a look at this. This is the forest where we are now. This is the swamp that lies ahead of us. And further on, there is the holy mountain that vomits fire.
And beyond that?
No one has ever succeeded in going beyond this boundary. But wherever they go, we will follow them.
Again, I beseech you, Tatius, it is not wise to dare the unknown.
The earth always swallows up whoever dares cross it.
Let us abandon those miserable curs to their own madness.
And my daughter?
I understand your sorrow. And I share it with you. I loved Julia. She was going to be my bride. And you were like a father to me. But to the cruelty of fate, the wise surrender.
I never have. And it's too late in life for me to learn how. Forward! We shall continue!
Tracks have disappeared into the water.
There's no use going further. It's only a waste of time.
Sabines.
It looks like an advance patrol. We must warn the others.
Watch out, Romulus!
Killed if it hadn't been for you.
You needn't thank me, Sarah. I was happy to help you.
Maybe it would have been much better if you'd let the wagon fall on me. We'll never reach our destination.
That's not true, Sarah. There we'll have our own land, our own houses, a real city.
Do you really think so?
Of course I do. You have to believe it. It keeps your heart beating and gives you a reason for living. And a reason for dying, too. And we will all be united. We will be a people, don't you see?
Yes, dear, give it to me. I know a little more about knives than you do.
Don't let it bother you, Tarpeia. He'll never be able to get anywhere with that pretty Sabine girl. Julia's chosen another. Julia. The next time you leave camp, tell someone. There are many dangers in this forest.
Leave me alone. You're the only danger I have to fear. You call yourself a leader. You're no leader, you're a thief.
A thief for a kiss? I could do a great deal worse to you, Julia, and leave you to the buzzards afterwards.
You feel courageous because you know I'm alone. You wouldn't speak that way if Romulus were here.
My brother.
Yes, Romulus.
The only thing you're good for is the bed of that stupid Sabine who dresses like a warrior. I can sell you back to him. If I don't kill him first.
Remus. Remus, ever since we left Alba Longa, you haven't so much as spoken to me. You avoid me. You're infatuated with that Sabine girl, aren't you?
Be quiet. I've heard enough of women's talk.
I have eyes, I can see. You're just as bad as your brother, the two of you snarling over her like dogs.
Hurry, Remus. We've got to get the wagons moving. The Sabines are right behind us.
Give the alarm. Hurry, Romulus. On your horses! Get your possessions and load the wagons! Hurry! Move!
What are you doing, man? Get on the wagon!
A signal from Plastinus. It means they've sighted the rebels' caravan.
They're going to try to pass through the gully, but Plastinus will be able to stop them. Eklos, order the attack.
But our advance guards have already moved forward. They're ahead of the caravan now.
If any of them manage to escape, they'll find us waiting on the other side of the Mountain of Fire. We'll cut down every last one of those accursed traitors.
But if the caravan is doomed already, why should we risk the dangers of the mountain? It would be wiser to wait here.
Yours is not the counsel of wisdom, Curtius, but of fear. Everyone shall learn how a Sabine king takes revenge for an affront. It isn't only because of my daughter. There's something more mysterious and important at stake. Is King Tashus or those rebels? Thus it is written.
Hurry! Faster!
Romulus, Remus, look! A bridge! See it?
It'll hold only a few people at a time. Yes, we'll have to leave the wagons behind.
Abandon the wagons! Take the weapons and food and join the march! Hurry!
We have to cross over the bridge. Get down from the wagons. Hurry!
Hurry! Cross the bridge.
The Sabines are right behind us. Move!
We'll never make it. The Sabines are too close.
Let's face them here in open battle.
They wipe us out.
We'll give Tasha something to remember us by.
What will you do?
Come with me.
Have the guards replied?
The blood will not clot.
You know me not at all, Plastinus. It would take more than this to hold me. The augury may be uncertain. It may even be against us, but we'll continue.
Right. On your horses! Let's go!
Be down on us.
Here they are.
We'll have to retreat.
Come on, let's go.
Don't wait any longer. Come with me.
Hurry, hurry. Across the bridge. Let's go.
Unfortunately, this won't be enough to stop them. We must move on quickly.
One day we will meet again, my friend.
Look at them. They prepare for the battle, even though they know now that they're not invincible. Your warriors.
100 of my best men on the death of Plastinus. A trusted commander. The price is too high for a few miserable wagons.
You never worried about price before. You were always willing to spend whatever was necessary to hold your throne. You've heard about these two brothers with your very own ears. You know of the miraculous origin. Why do you continue? You can't fight against two gods.
It's only a legend. It originated in our country after the coming of Aeneas the Trojan. May the gods curse him.
Since when do you believe in the gods? Ever since your power began to slip through your fingers like so many grains of sand?
Be careful of what you say, Curtius. This ridiculous fable must be extinguished before rebellion spreads among my people like a contagious disease. And it is not in wine that you'll find the courage to accomplish this task.
I hold to this enterprise, Texas. Because now I have nothing. Nothing left. I haven't even the courage to run away. You know I'm a coward, and that's why you've been using me. Giving me your daughter to increase your power even more. Your daughter. She loves you as much as she loves me. As much as your subjects love you. As much as her mother ever loved you, a slave that you had only through violence.
The past is always full of shadows, Curtius. Don't ever forget that. You keep your mind on serving me. Every one of us has a mission in life, as the victor or as the vanquished. And yours, Curtius, is that of the vanquished.
Let's not fool ourselves, my friends. I believe the time has come for us to face reality. The groups of Umbrians, the peasants of Martina, above all the old men, are about to give up. One of the reasons is that they believe less and less in your prophecy. How long can we last under these conditions?
As long as it pleases the gods.
We cannot go blindly on like this. The sacrifice made by Publius and your own quick wits were able to save us when we crossed over the suspension bridge, but tomorrow...
This is not the time to complain. We all knew when we left Alba Longa that we were facing the unknown. Now we only have to outdistance the Sabine cavalry in order to gain enough time to build our first defenses on the land which will be ours.
I know. You are sincere, Romulus, and the words come from your heart. But even if we are not stopped by the Sabine lances, something else is bound to deter us. Hunger, fevers.
Croak like a bird of ill omen.
Listen to me, all of you. Our destiny is before us. All we have to do is reach out and grab it. If any man here refuses to sacrifice everything, then he is a servant and a slave.
Remus, a good leader does not speak that way.
We want a city of our own, just like you do, Remus.
But if we all should die in this headlong race, what can we expect to build? A city of corpses? True, you're the one who is leading us. We agree, but you are an ambitious man, and often a cruel one.
Be quiet, old man!
You shouldn't have done that, Remus.
I know what should be done and what shouldn't be done. You keep out of this, Romulus. There is only one leader here, me.
That's a decision you made on your own. Our mother's dying wish was that we live in agreement and together build the city.
The gods have chosen me, and by the gods, I'll convince you!
If you're trying to provoke me, you won't succeed. I'd never fight my brother.
The gods will indicate who is to lead us. It is foolish not to consult them first.
Tomorrow at sunrise, when the campfires are all burned out, the vultures in the sky shall be counted.
You shall stand separated by no less than 5 bow lengths. He who counts the greater number of vultures is the king, with the favor of the gods.
So be it.
Romulus. Forgive him, Romulus. But I think it's just exhaustion that made him speak that way.
We're all tired. But if we fight among ourselves, we shall never reach our goal.
Be patient with him. You must rest.
You're the most gentle, beautiful creature I've ever known, Julia.
4 black and 8 white. The gods have decided.
Romulus is our king!
Long live Romulus!
May the gods' decision be respected, brother. But you'll always be at my side.
I don't want your generosity. I know your kindness. I'm tired of it, Romulus. I don't accept this verdict. This whole undertaking was my idea, and I shall be the leader in the end.
It isn't the flight of a few stupid birds, but the sword that shall decide which of us is the leader. Show them your courage, Romulus.
Don't insult the gods, Remus.
They've already indicated their desire.
I told you before, and I repeat it. I'll never fight you.
Because you're a coward!
No! Don't draw your sword, Romulus. He is your brother. By not respecting the verdict of the gods, in the test that you agreed to of your own free will, you have committed a grave sacrilege. Nobody would accept you as our leader now. Don't you understand?
Yes, I understand. Have you forgotten the expeditions I led you on? You, Achilles, have you forgotten that I saved your life and yours, Godar? And now you want to abandon me?
I'm ready to follow you, Remus, but not against your own brother.
I will follow you, too. Very well. Our paths separate here.
You are your own master. Whoever wants may follow.
Divide the caravan.
Of course. Dividing the caravan's a good idea. The separate tracks would confuse the Sabines.
And whoever arrives first will dig the furrow and found the city. And at last we'll be a people.
Fate is always on the side of the strongest, Romulus. Remember that.
I'm gonna miss you.
Don't let it worry. We'll meet again. You'll see.
Bye, Romulus.
Go in peace.
Please don't be angry because I've decided to follow your brother. You see, I owe him my life.
Go, Achilles. We'll meet again in the Valley of the Seven Hills.
May the gods hear you. I promise to look after your brother. You needn't worry.
Thank you, my friend.
Please don't cry, Hester. We're not going to be separated forever. We'll soon meet again, you'll see.
I couldn't bear being without Achilles. I love him. And I'm going with him.
If you really love him, you'd do well to follow him.
Goodbye, Julia.
Goodbye, Achilles. Take care of her. Gods will watch over you.
Let's go, Hestia.
And you, Tarpeia, I wish you luck.
Spare me your wishes, Sabine. And don't flatter yourself you've won. Nobody can see into the future.
That is true. It is not in our power to know the future, but there is something else that gives warmth and heart to life. A force I've come to know, Tarpeia, called love.
Or hate. And I hate you for what you are. For what you've been able to change in a man's heart. For the unfair protection that you are granted by the gods.
Leave the gods in peace and call your feelings by their real name, Tarpeia. You're just jealous.
The adventure hasn't yet come to an end. If we should ever meet again, watch out.
That day I shall be with the man I love. And that is enough. I hope you will be able to say the same, Tarpeia. And know what it is to be happy.
There are many ways to love, Julia. But you are much too different to understand. Here, take this knife. If Romulus is overcome, may the gods give you the strength to use it on yourself.
Leave her alone, Tarpeia. Get back to the cart immediately. That's the kind of woman to have on a journey like this. The others?
You mean like me?
You despise me, I know.
I don't despise you, Julia. Even though you are the cause of our tribe separating.
I thought that there was a different reason.
There are many reasons. But the real one is that I envy him. He's always been the luckier. And he'll be luckier this time, too, you'll see. But the last word hasn't been said yet. My will is strong enough to bend even the fates.
Farewell.
Farewell, may the gods...
Those who have decided to go with Remus are out of their minds. They're taking the path across the mountain.
It's the shortest way, but it's the most dangerous.
That mountain is sacred to the gods of Hades. Remus should not defy them.
That's why he chose it. To defy the gods and himself.
It's no use looking back. You must forget.
We march. Take the path through the woods. Why are you crying?
Everything that's happened is my fault. If you'd never met me, you'd now be marching side by side with your brother. I've separated you, and now I'm afraid, Romulus. I'm afraid for you.
It isn't your fault. We were born the same day, under the same sign, but with different destinies. I never wanted to be the leader. We could make our decisions together, but Remus knows only one law, force.
I beg you, Romulus. Let me leave. I've got to stop my father.
No, Julia. It's too late. Your future's mine. You're mine. I don't know what's at the end of the journey, but we'll welcome it.
Yes, we'll welcome it. Together. Let your provisions fall on the ground. Well, go on, pick them up.
Do you want to die of hunger? Don't stop now!
Jove, our omnipotent father, you who hold the lives and destinies of men in the palm of your hand, save his life. Take mine in exchange, but save his life. Save his life.
No. No, it's not true. Leave me. Leave me.
Don't be afraid, my love. You're alive. We're alive.
But she's the woman of that band of thieves. I recognize her. You don't intend to spare her, do you?
No. But she must tell us something before she dies. The others, where are they? Where is my daughter?
Speak up!
Speak. For your own benefit.
Why should I talk? What would you give me in return?
A rapid and painless death for you and your companion.
Give us our lives and a horse, and I'll tell you what you want to know.
And you dare to suggest that I should bargain with you? Your life depends on a gesture from me.
If I should die, you would never find your daughter, nor your enemies.
Would you prefer it if we tortured you?
Try it, Tassius. Try it!
Very well, then. I promise to spare the lives of both of you. You have my word of honor.
Your daughter is with the others, with Romulus. She lives with the women of the caravan as their equal. They took the path through the woods and are circling that mountain which stands guard over the Valley of the Seven Hills.
We must overtake them before they organize and build their first defenses. Take the path through the woods.
Do you really mean to let these two live?
I have given my word. One who betrays, as she has done, does not deserve to live, I know. But we shall leave it to the gods to punish her, and as for that man, he already has his destiny. As have all of us.
What's the matter, Romulus? You don't seem happy.
I wish Remus was here.
We're here! We're here!
You must be calm, Remus. You've lost a great deal of blood.
Where are the others? Achilles, Godar.
We're the only survivors.
Oh.
They were swallowed by the mountain. They had angered the gods. But you, Remus, are still alive. Even Romulus is lost now. The Sabines will destroy him before he can lay a single brick of the city that is rightfully yours.
You're wrong.
No. Because I told the Sabines which way they'd gone in exchange for your life.
What did you say? What did you say?
But there was nothing else I could do, don't you understand? They came upon us while you were still unconscious, and I had to save your life no matter what. We've been left all alone, but I'll take care of you. I'll save you. Ah!
You're crazy! No one shall have my city! I will be king if I have to kill my brother.
Remus, I beg of you, don't go. Don't go!
I'll never give up. Never!
Listen to me, Remus, I implore you. Heed the signs. The response of the vultures. The curse of the mountain of fire. Think of those who have died to follow you. To follow this impossible dream of yours. I beg of you, Remus, please don't go after him. I pray you. Listen to me. Nobody has the power to change his destiny. Nobody, nobody, not even you.
The destiny of others, perhaps, but certainly not mine.
No, no, Remus. No, Remus, don't leave me here. No. I beg of you, Remus, don't go away, Remus.
Straight and aim high.
Is this the way?
That's right.
Hurry, women! Fill the trench! They're likely to attack at any time!
King.
You have guided us wisely. Up on the hill, we would have been too far away from the river, and water is necessary for the life of man.
You surprise me, Numa. You sound like a king.
Numa's young. Every young man feels like a king.
Do you intend to wait forever for the brother who has abandoned you?
Remus wanted this undertaking. We must wait for him. He's my brother. I owe him my life.
No, Romulus. This time you're wrong. It was not only to save you that Remus decided to attack Alba Longa. It was because your father, before he died, had told Remus something that roused his ambition. Those dying words planted in his heart the desire for power, and for that reason he attacked, not to save you. You were only an excuse.
Take back what you said.
Beat me to death if you like. That won't change the truth.
Romulus! The Sabines!
Where?
On the hill over there. Hundreds of them.
They've overtaken us.
They're over there, too. Look, Romulus.
We're surrounded. We don't have a chance. There's only one thing we can do. Fight.
They have 10 times as many soldiers as we do. Let me try to go to my father. He mustn't shed any more blood for me.
No, Julia. It's not only for you. We'll fight for our land and our future.
I've been waiting for this moment. The chase is over.
Divide the men into groups.
Right.
This is the chance we've
been
waiting
over
for.
There.
When they attack us, we'll show them who we are.
It'll be a great day.
By the gods, we'll raise the walls of our city with stones already stained with glory.
Those accursed rebels have completely surrounded their camp with trenches. It will be almost impossible to get through their defenses.
I'm afraid you worry too much, Curtius.
What do you mean by that?
That the road to the throne of Alba Longa and mine is much easier to travel by taking the hand of my daughter in marriage than by risking your life in battle.
I find your words offensive.
You can show me how wrong I am. You shall have the honor of leading the attack.
But that means suicide, Tatius. And besides, that's what you have your commanders for.
In this army, it's King Tatius who decides. Lead the attack, Curtius.
But it means death. It means certain death. Much better to give up, Julia. Much better to give up everything.
You don't have anything left to give up. Don't you remember saying so yourself?
Here!
Inside. Hurry!
strike the blow. I'll show you how a king dies.
No, Romulus! Father, I've lived with these people of my own will. I was free. I shared their hopes and dreams. It was my own decision, because I love him so.
On this land, consecrated by the blood of our people, we shall build a city, and no one will be able to stop us. Decide, Tashus.
Let there be peace between us.
Of the immortal gods, I, Romulus, am now king of this city. This furrow marks its boundaries. Who crosses it unarmed is our friend. He who is armed must die. This is the law.
Long live Romulus! Long live Romulus!
City or of your city? Of our city, my brother. I'll never share anything with you. Look! Look, I have already destroyed your city.
No!
Look at your king crawling on the ground. Is this your leader, the one you chose to defend you? He's as weak as the city he'll build for you. Get up, Romulus. Or I'll kill you where you are, like a worm.
You're the one who wanted this, Remus.
He's broken the law. You've got to kill him, Romulus.
City with my sword.
Ah!
Remus. My brother.
It was not you who decided our destiny. We cannot go against our fate. Oh. No one shall challenge your power now. And the city which you shall build be as great as the one I dreamed of. Oh.
Remus!
This is the end of the legend, and the beginning of the story of the greatest city in the world, the Eternal City, Rome.